Hello everybody and welcome to the introductory lesson of thermodynamics. So, starting with the important question is, what is thermodynamics all about? And I have to say, this is one of the most powerful topics that you will ever explore in the branch of physics. Thermodynamics is the study of transferring energy, obtaining energy, applying those energy, and you can see that all sorts of applications on energy transfers around you is based on the principle of thermodynamics. So, in this lecture series, we will develop skills and analytical tools that allow us to understand and quantify various systems. To be very specific, we are going to discuss about topics of mass, energy conservation principles, we will look the different law analysis and how to apply those on open and closed systems. And in addition, we will investigate different properties that allow us to explore these systems. We will also look at the behavior and application of specific thermodynamic systems at steady-state conditions. In this session, we are going to talk about the first law of thermodynamics and how it relates to internal energy, heat and work. So, what is the basic idea behind the first law of thermodynamics? Well, the gist of it is just like this. Energy cannot be created or destroyed. It can simply be transferred from one place to another. So, let's say if we have a system and everything outside of it is the environment, right? Or you can say, in the language of thermodynamics, it is surroundings. So, energy can flow into or out of the system, and it's two ways in which energy can do so, okay? That is through heat and another is work. So, if heat flows into the system gains energy, and that energy is known as the internal energy of the system. Represented by the symbol capital U. Now, the surroundings can also do work on a system, okay? So, those are the two ways in which a system can increase its internal energy. It's by the transfer of a heat energy into the system, or if the environment or surroundings perform work on a system. So, let's say if the surroundings perform 500 joules of work on a system. That means that system's internal energy goes up by 500. So, the change is positive, right? Therefore, delta U increases. And the energy of the surroundings, however, has to decrease by 500, right? And so, in this case, observe that energy is not created or destroyed. It's simply transferred from one place to another. The system didn't just get the 500 joules from anywhere, right? That 500 joules of energy came from somewhere, yeah? It came from the surroundings. A good way to illustrate this is, let's think about money. For example, suppose you decide to sell your bike for $400. And let's assume someone is purchasing that bike. Let's say your friend buy that. So in this case, your bank account will increase by 400 and your friend's bank account will decrease by 400. And so the money just doesn't came from anywhere, right? It doesn't just fall from the sky magically, yeah? It came from your friend. So in order for you to gain 400, someone has to lose 400, right? So, in everyday life, in practical sense, when someone gains money, someone has to lose the money. And so, in that sense, within that transaction, money is not created or destroyed. It's simply transferred from one place to another, right? Similarly, energy also follows that same principle. Energy cannot be created or destroyed. It's simply transferred from one place to another. In our example, if the system gains 500 joules of energy, that means the surrounding definitely lose 500 joules of energy, yeah? Because energy is not created or destroyed. So, this is the first law of thermodynamics. Now, there are three types of systems that you will be encounter here. The first one is an open system, the second one is a closed system, and the third one is an isolated system, okay? So, what these are? Well, in the open system, matter can enter, okay? For example, oxygen from the air can go inside of it. Heat energy can flow into an open system. Therefore, matter and energy can be transferred into and out of an open system. In a closed system, matter cannot flow into it. Oxygen just can't go inside of a closed system, yeah? However, energy can still flow into a closed system. So, in a closed system, only energy can go into and out of it, but matter cannot, okay? And in an isolated system, neither energy nor matter can enter or leave. Therefore, the mass within an isolated system is fixed, it is constant, it doesn't change, okay? And the total energy of an isolated system also doesn't change, because no energy can flow into it or out of it. The equation for the change in the internal energy of a system is Q plus W. And this is the equation that you will see in a typical physical chemistry textbook, okay? Here, Q represents the heat energy that flows into or out of the system. And W represents the work. Now, in your physics textbook, this equation is a bit different. In your physics textbook, you will see that delta U is equals Q minus W. And you might be wondering, why is it so? Why is this different, yeah? Well, the reason for that is the point of view taken by the scientists. For example, in chemistry, scientists took the system's point of view, while in physics, engineers took the point of view of the surroundings. So, in chemistry, W is negative when work is done by the system. Anytime work is done by the system has to expend energy to do the work, yeah? And therefore, the internal energy of the system decreases. Imagine you are going to the gym to work out, okay? And as you lift weights, what will happen? Your body will burn energy and the internal energy of your body will decrease. So, as your calorie burns, simultaneously your work is being done by the system. That is, you are the system here and you are doing this work. And the surroundings might be the weights that you are lifting. It burns your calories to lift up. So, as you burn calories to lift up a weight from, let's say, the ground to an elevated position, the potential energy of that weight increases, yeah? But the internal energy of your body decreases, right? Because you are burning the calories. It is you who are losing the weight. In this case, W is negative because work is done by the system in the case of chemistry. And when W is positive, when work is done on a system, okay? So let's analyze these two cases individually. When work is done by the system, in chemistry, when work is done by the system, as you said before, the internal energy decreases. And because the energy of the system is decreasing, work is negative. Remember, we are talking the viewpoint of the system. In physics, we want to take the viewpoint of the surroundings. So, when work is done by the system, the internal energy of the system still decreases. However, we say W is positive because the surrounding is gaining energy. Yeah? We are taking the viewpoint of the surroundings. And so, since the surroundings gain energy, W is positive. In the case of chemistry, when work is done by the system loses energy. So, we say W is negative. And so, it is the viewpoint. And that's why the equations are a bit different. So, if you are focused on the surroundings, then W is positive because the energy of the surrounding is going up. Whereas, if you focus on a system, the system loses energy when work is done by the system. And so, W is negative. But in this session, I am going to take the system perspective, okay? So, going back to this equation, delta U is Q plus W. You need to know that Q is positive. Whenever the system, meaning the reactants and the products, absorb heat energy. So, anytime heat flows into the system, heat energy is absorbed by the system. Thus, Q is positive. And this is an endothermic process. Whenever heat energy is absorbed. On the other hand, Q is negative whenever the system releases heat energy. And so, heat energy flows out of the system into the surroundings. And this is known as exothermic process. So, anytime heat energy is released, it's exothermic. And when heat energy is absorbed by the system, it's endothermic, okay? So, for an exothermic process, Q is negative. And for an endothermic process, Q is positive. And as was mentioned before, W is positive when work is done on the system, that is in chemistry. And W is negative whenever work is done by the system, that is in physics. So, you need to be familiar with the sign conventions if you are gonna use this equation.